They're 7-1. What is there to talk about? I guess they're great. They scored more runs than other teams have scored in full seasons. They have more walks than every other team. They have more hits than every other team. They, after 8 games, have more runs than almost every other team in the last 4 years for the full season.
That's a sick number.
It's crazy.
I know. I was hearing about that.
It's crazy. They're hitting the cover off the ball. I think they play good defense also. Leo's doing his thing. Where are the holes on this team, if anything?
Okay, so, you know...
Because, T.I., you can't show up against the Tigers and be fearful.
I don't fear anybody.
So, what are you going to tell your squad?
I'll tell you right now.
When they see Abadi and Jimmy, I mean, those are two of the best hitters right there, and then everyone else they have. What are you going to tell your squad?
First of all, you have no fear, all right? Everybody's beatable. And
how do you not fear them at 7-1? Tell me.
How do I not fear them?
How do I not fear them? Because they scored 80 runs already in 6
wonderful.
Games.
That's great. You know, I'm very happy for them, and they're playing great, but I do not fear them.
Okay.
My team does not fear them. We will not fear them. We will not fear anybody. If you're going to beat us, you're going to beat us. You're going to have to beat us up because we're going to keep on coming. We've done it all year, by the way. We've been down in games, and we just keep coming and coming and coming. We don't stop. That's the veteran presence we have on our team. We understand.
It's huge.
We understand. Game's not over till it's over.
Right.
But... they have holes. I've watched them play. I'd rather not talk about it here. I'd keep it to myself with my team on where their holes are. And they have them. They're 7-1, but they've had a couple games where they easily should have lost.
100%.
All right. So to say that they're unbeatable is absolutely not the case.
Right.
They're 100% beatable. Do I think Max shuts them down in those situations where we're ahead and it's in the seventh inning and they have 2 outs? Or whatever the situation, yes, Max shuts them down. Max gets out of it.
Yeah.
Max is a champion. He's a recent champion, all right? If I would have put my faith in anybody in a situation like that, I'm putting it in Max. He'll find a way to get the out.
You know what? It's so hard for these great pitchers like Nate B to say, you know what? Take your base.
You got to walk him.
Because it's almost like an ego thing. It must be like an ego thing.
Yeah, no.
Why else wouldn't you walk him?
Okay. The problem with that is that Nate B is also the captain.
Right.
So the captain can't tell him, I'm overriding you.
Right.
You're going to first.
Get the first.
Get the first. You walk Abadi there. You walk him there. It's a simple, is it a two-time MVP, two-time defending MVP?
Yeah, I don't even care if he's a zero-time MVP. The situation calls for the walk.
It calls for the walk, you're right, because then you have force plays also.
Yeah, why do I dribblers. Need a ground ball to third? Why do I need to throw the ball?
All the way across the diamond.
Just touch third and get out of dodge.
You have a million different, you have to walk him there, but that was an ego thing for Nabi. See, that's the problem, though. That becomes a problem.
He's the captain and the pitcher. It's hard.
It's hard.
A.B. Yeah. Sacka did it for years. He told me it's hard. He told me coming into this year, I will not be captain. I need to pitch. Speaking of that, A.B. Sacka, he usually gets better as the warmer weather comes.
Right.
He did get hit. I'm not thrilled with his defense. I mean, I thought their D was going to be locked down. They do have Joey Cohen and Max and Gabe. They have a really good infield. I don't know.
We swept them.
What's the story with their team?
We beat them up pretty good. They had a 7-2 lead on us in game two.
Yes.
And again, I'm going to come back to it. A.B. Sack is a great pitcher, right? He's been a great pitcher for many years in the league, right?
Mm-hmm.
Has he gotten better? No. You know what I'm saying? He hasn't gotten better. All due respect, I don't mean it in a negative way. He hasn't gotten better. Everybody else has got better. The hitters got better, and we caught up to him, and... I'm sorry. You're going to get hit. He's going to get hit.
It's very interesting. You're not saying any of these guys got worse. You're saying they just stayed.
They stayed there.
And these guys
were up here at one point. The batters were here.
Right.
The batters are up here now. They're level with you, if not passing you.
Right.
You better do something about it. Because if you don't, you're going to get hit. This league, every lineup, from top to bottom, everybody can hit. Versus us, I mean, last week, Hubba Bubba, the bottom of their lineup was hitting the hell out of, and this is Maxie Deed.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you don't pitch well, they're going to hit you.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's It's impressive. The league has gotten impressive. It really is. I
the
love
Hubba
this league.
Bubba bottom of the lineup are all guys that, if they perform, they could be good. They haven't been performing all year until that. This is
they
the first time.
They performed last week.
They came home and felt decent about the way they played, you know?
Yeah. No, they were impressive. So, yeah, I didn't get to tell you about yada, 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 by the way. It was a good team.
Yeah.
They're a good team.
I'm high on that team also, which is surprising because I don't like slow teams in this league because I love stealing the
I'm
extra
base. I'm always
base.
About speed. I'm very big on speed.
Huge
I get it.
Huge on that.
But Ralph is pitching great.
It's a different type of team. They really hit, and their hits are real hits.
No, they hit. They can hit. That team could play. Listen, we won game one versus them, and I thought we would sweep them, and it wasn't going to happen. And Sammy Esses.
Wait, is he always that good at third?
Yes.
Guys, makes every play. Dude,
I don't understand anybody. So, again, he's my co-captain in the night league,
okay.
Right? 2 years ago, he was Gold Glove. He won the Gold Glove. The guy is amazing.
Yeah.
He makes all his plays. He's not going to give you the diving, spectacular play, but you don't need that.
You don't need that.
He'll make every play, and he's very smart. He's very smart out there. He knows the situation of what's going on around him. So I love Sammy. I love Sammy to death. So that's a very good team. That was a steal at that
steal.
Number. Steal.
And how about Dano? Talking about ego of captains, he's been playing third base for a long
time. Dano has no ego.
He moved himself to second base.
Dano has no ego. Never had an ego.
And then he took a shot off the head at
right
second base.
Versus us.
Which, go figure, the hot corner is where you'd think that happened. Bro. All those years it didn't happen.
And then Dano's crazy. Dano starts throwing up. And now we're like getting scared. We're like, Dano, you're throwing up here. You got to go to the hospital. He's like, no, I always throw up. I'm like, what does that mean? We just throw up randomly? He's like, yeah. I'm
and
like, okay.
The clucking on your team is hilarious.
It's funny. You know, it's DK. DK is hysterical
it's
when he's
hilarious.
And Abe Shamba, these guys are funny.
It just comes out of nowhere. There's no rhythm to it, which is the funniest part of it.
Dude, these guys are going to Yankee games, sending us videos of Yankee games that clucking at the Yankee games, these guys,
crazy.
You know?
So Sammy Esses is a veteran. But this team just hits.
Good
they
team.
Really do.
Excellent team. You know what's great about this league? I'm telling you, on any given Sunday, anybody could beat anybody, and it's that simple. It really is. You better come to play.
Yeah.
You better come to play.
It's funny. As slow as I think they are because of the bottom of their lineup, S's, Jake, meaning Jake Yogi, you know, Dano also is faster than you would think. Ralph Hannon is faster than I thought he was. H, they also have Jake Dweck.
Yeah.
Erwin Cohen.
Absolute Erwin.
Al Zolta.
Erwin playing unbelievable. Yeah, their outfield is
speedy. That outfield
is
incredible.
Let me tell you, Al Zolta made a catch on Froggy that was unbelievable.
Another
over
underrated right fielder.
Yeah, over the shoulder catch. It was. Thought it was a home run, and he made a great catch. So, listen, again, and I'll say it over and over again. People talk about, you know, every team is going to have certain weaknesses, but every team is strong. If you do not come to play, you're going to lose.
Does it drive you crazy when you see a highlight of slapping the base? Charles Sacca coming off of second
goodness.
On an infield fly. A rule that
but
he
was
taught
standing there. He was standing there first. He didn't move until Jack went over to him. He was there the whole time. What made him move at that point? I don't
no
understand.
Idea.
I got to ask him that question.
Or shimmy, not going. Forget halfway. The correct move is he should be on second base by that time. And if the guy catches it, you retreat to first. There's no tag up in that situation. Do these things drive you crazy when you
do.
Watch the highlights?
They would drive me crazy as a captain. But again, I think that comes down to preparation. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm sure that situation's happened to Shimmy 1,000 times.
Yeah.
And he's probably done the right thing, you know, most of the time.
Yeah, he's a great player.
I think it's the mindset of the team that seeps into individual plays, if that makes sense. So if you have a team that the whole season from before the season, first of all, I always believe it all starts before the season,
mm-hmm.
before you get on the field. Mm-hmm. How you guys are going to play starts before that. But if you have a team that is constantly in a reminding mode where things like that are going to happen during the season, that this is what you got to do, this is what you got to do, it's going to come natural. You know, I don't think they have that on that team. I think it's more an individual guys than a team pulling all in the same direction.
The Tigers have that because they had a play where it was a tag up for the game. Guys
on
third.
Tigers have certain guys on that team that do this.
And I heard three guys yelling. There was men on the corners, let's say. I heard them all selling the guy on first base. Don't tag. If they tag you before he scores,
you stay.
We
right
don't
there.
Get the run.
Right,
you
right.
stay there.
Right.
And you tag up.
Right.
You
see, and you know? That's a mindset that happens on the team. And I'll bet you, nobody, you didn't hear a word
right.
of anybody saying, you know, make sure you make that turn. Make sure before guys getting up, you're trying to tell them in certain situations what might happen.
But you're right. It's the reminder because everyone knows that.
It's correct.
You could forget when you're out there, but they didn't let you forget.
But as a team, if that's not happening consistently,
right.
consistently, then it's not happening.
Mm-hmm.
There's two types of teams, right? You can have those guys, the teams that are constantly doing that for each other, then the teams that don't.
Amazing that on that field back there, two times this year, in the seventh inning with an 8-5 lead, the team with five won the game. And it changed the seasons around. Hubba Bubba was 2-0, Mo Money was 0-2, 8-5 game in the seventh inning. And then over here, slapping the base could have saved their season with a win against the Tigers.
Right.
They could have been 2-6, one game out. Tigers could have been 6-2.
They had the bottom of the order, right?
Yeah, 6-2, one game up. The last one was worse because it all but eliminated them, let's say. And also, there were two outs, nobody on. I mean, it's just an incredible loss. I mean,
this year, I've noticed there's been a lot of comebacks this year.
Yes.
A lot of comebacks.
Los Caballos comes back every time they're losing.
Listen, they're a good team. We played them week one. I like that team. That team is dangerous.
I like that team also.
They're a dangerous team, and Farca is an intense guy.
Yeah.
You know, so he's gonna have his team ready to play. They're gonna come, and they're gonna come with emotion, and they're gonna come hard. And he's the best instigator there is in the entire league. He knows how to get under people's skins. He knows how to get the other team off their game.
But he can't do what he did. He can't go into their huddle.
Right, you see.
That could have resulted in a brawl.
Right, so I'm going to tell you.
He can't do that.
He did it to me last year in the playoffs. Like, he was getting under my skin. And, you know, and...
You got
to
be smarter with it.
You got it.
He could jog by you and say something under his breath.
He's good at it.
But you can't do that, what he did. And he knows he can't do that.
Right,
that was too much. Because that could result in... If Hubba Bubba had a pulse that day, there would have been a brawl. It would have been, you know, I mean...
In our dugout, in our... That would have been a brawl. That would have been. Hank would have tackled somebody.
Any team with a pulse would have not have let themselves be stepped on like that.
Edmund would have probably killed somebody.
Yeah,
Edmund would have
buried somebody. It's crazy. Do you want to do predictions, T.I.?
Let's do it. I love predictions.
Toledo Mudhens are 5-3.
5-3.
Mo Money is also 5-3.
Great team. I love that team. I love Mo.
I assume Mo Money will have JT back now.
And I'm happy about that. I'm happy about that. Yeah. I really am. I mean,
he wasn't missing a game for
nonsense
to go on vacation.
That he's playing because he's, you know, these are the kind of guys you want on the field. You want the best players on the field. You never want them hurt or have any issues or anything of that nature. So I'm really happy he'll be back. And they're a good team. I like them a lot. But again, you know, you want me to say split this and that? I can't.
You can't.
Because that's just not who I am.
Right.
You know, so I'm going to say we're going to sweep them.
If there's a sweep in that game, it's a humongous shakeup for one of the teams.
Huge. That'll, you know, lock you in, almost lock you into those top two seeds as long as you play fairly decent the last 2 weeks of the season.
How good is this time of year?
This is the best time of the year.
I mean,
this is all the fun. This is when it all happens.
At 5-3, a team could go to 7-3.
This is
a team could fall to 5-5.
That's a huge difference. This is when men are made. You know what I'm saying? Listen, you know, one of my favorite movies is Miracle.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the 1980
best. What's his name, the coach?
Herb Brooks.
So,
greatest line ever. You know, he said, I sent this out to the team the other day, but yeah, it said, great moments are born from great opportunities. You know, and if you just stop and put it in perspective for a second,
mm-hmm.
every week we have, you know, there are great opportunities for you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you want to have those great moments, and you need to build those great moments coming into the playoffs. So, there's going to be a lot of fun going on with a lot of teams.
Yeah.
And I think it's going to be really interesting to see how it all shakes out. And I think if you, at any given point, if you look too far ahead, you're going to have issues. Because every team can beat you. And there's no doubt in my mind.
This Mo Money team might have the best lineup in the YMSL.
Unbelievable.
I mean, Tigers have the best lineup.
Tigers are insane.
But this Mo Money team after the Tigers, let's say, everyone talks about the big four, right? MC, JT, Jordy, and John. John, you forget about some of the superstars on this team. But even after that, you got to look at a Mo Cass.
Mo Cass, let me tell you something. Mo Cass is a beast.
You got to look at Ruby Shalhoub.
Ruben, what is he? What's going on with the? Yeah,
he hits. Constant. He hits.
They're deep. They're a deep lineup. Thank God we have Max.
Yeah.
that's what I'm going to tell you. Max, thank God we have you, man. You know, if there's one guy that could, listen, play good defense, pitch well, you'll have a chance to win. It's that simple.
I think, I don't think you're sweeping this team. I think their lineup is a little too strong. I don't see your team scoring double-digit runs in a game.
Why? We've done it before.
You have done it, but I'm going to go.
I'm going to tell you something.
Tell me. I'm about to make my prediction.
I'm going to tell you something. Everybody looks at our lineup and says it's not that good. I'm going to tell you this. When you have Nate Cush batting 8th or 9th.
Yeah.
And you have Benny, who I'm telling you, I'm telling everybody, man. People were down on him beginning of the season. Yeah. Down on him. Guy's putting his work in. And you can see the results are coming. Last week, game two, he was 4-for-4, something like that. Everything, line drive, up the middle.
Right.
It's coming. So when you have these guys batting it, and then understand, Froggy hasn't started hitting yet. He's going to hit.
What's up with the Frog?
It's in his mind. He gets so down on himself.
He's batting 0-12 or something. Let me tell you something, what is up with it?
Last week, he had a couple nice shots that were just caught. Mm-hmm. Line drives. He's coming out of it. Now, if he starts hitting, our lineup goes 1-10. Because DK, by the way, has been a beast.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Great. Every big rally we've had started with him.
Yeah.
Started with him getting on base.
He's the perfect 10 batter.
Perfect
10. Fast.
And
turns it over.
Line drives. And he understands his role. Of what he needs to do in that spot, which is great. So
the Knights trade with you gotta believe last year, or whatever that team was called, saved Abe Cowan because he was on, I don't know, he was just floating around for a couple of years.
Love this guy.
Him younger was one of the greatest talents I've ever seen. Then he seemed to have plateaued a little bit. When he got traded, I think it was a wake-up call like he never saw in his life. He played great on the Knights, like he played 10 years ago.
He beat us. That he made a catch versus us, mm-hmm, off of Buka, Big Buka.
Okay.
He crushed this ball, I'm telling you. Mm-hmm. And this guy went full airborne.
Yes.
To make this catch. And it was one of the best catches I've ever seen. And it saved the season. Because if he doesn't make that catch, that's a home run. We win that game easily going away. And it's a whole different day. He saved that game, that series for them. And it was a catch that I will never forget. I'm telling you, it was that good of a catch.
Well, I'll tell you this. When he got traded, you hear it in his voice. There was a video that went out. I can't believe I got traded or something like that. And I'm going to show everybody. And you just saw it in his voice. Like, he was so insulted that he was included in the trade. Like, I'm what you're getting rid of on this team. I'm going to show you now. And now it carried over into this year. He's playing tremendous.
He's been amazing. And let me tell you something. In center field, this guy makes it look easy. Mm-hmm. I mean, he makes it look easy. There are plays where I really think it's going to be difficult, and he's just there waiting, like it's having a cup of coffee on the way down.
But I'm telling
his bat has been amazing.
Mo Money's too strong, though, man. This team is awesome.
Listen, they're good.
I got to go with split here. I think
we're going to score a lot of runs on them. I really do.
I'm going to go with the split.
I feel you. I can see where you think a split's going to happen. But again, I'll never say my team's going to lose a game.
Okay, ever. I hear you.
Ever. So I can never say that. So
I would love to make a team shake up the standings a little bit. You know, I don't love going split, but I can't see Mo Money getting swept. And Yadid, like I've been saying lately, hasn't gotten swept in a few seasons now.
Right, no. And anytime we lose game one, he shuts it down game two.
But he's playing with fire with his game one performances over a couple of years now. He's not doing great in game ones.
And I think I have a solution for that.
You got to throw cold water on him in the morning or something. Show up at 5 in the morning and tell Max, get up and stop pitching.
Well, you know I'm awake. So
you know, I know you're here.
No, I think I have a solution for that. But again, there's things I want him to do, mm-hmm, during the course of a game. And he's just not so comfortable doing it yet, but it'll come. So Max is only getting better.
Get back 4-4, Los Caballos 4-4, another matchup of like teams that have the same record. Your prediction, sir? Get back, A.B. Sacker, Max Sutton, Joey Cohen, Gabe Abadi.
Joe G. How about, he's a beast. He's ridiculous.
Nothing to talk about there.
He had two shots off us. I don't think they landed yet.
he's had all the real home runs, like, you know,
real home runs. You get the single that turns it to a home run. Right. No, his home runs, I tell you, I don't think they landed. I think they went over this fence. They might have hit a house.
One went over there. One went over there.
Like, what is that? It's just not normal. I turn
insane
around.
Insane player.
You tip your cap to the guy. But,
insane player.
They have a great team that have underperformed. They're an underperforming team. Mm-hmm. They really are a truly underperforming team, and I think they're going to continue to underperform. And it's no knock against anybody. I just think sometimes, you know, even though you have a good team, it just doesn't click. Mm-hmm. And I haven't seen it click for them yet. So I'm going to go sweep Los Caballos.
I am going to agree with you and go sweep Los Caballos. I like the way Los Caballos is coming together. I like the way they've responded. I think they still have some weaknesses.
100%.
Third base, they put Jake Braha there. One week he was good. The next week he wasn't good.
Jake's a good ball player.
He's a good ball player. He's clearly an athlete. The guy's in shape. Yeah. He doesn't have this issue over here. I mean, he's overall, he'll be good.
He beat us, by the way.
But I don't know if he could be relied on in the hot corner over the course of the season. Fonz, that catcher, got to make a few more plays. They definitely have some weaknesses. What are they doing with David Richte? He was at third. They moved him to short center. Sometimes he's in right. They have issues, but I like how they're coming together. Farca hasn't contributed that much himself so far. You know what he is.
Farca's Farca. I mean, you really, you know, but you see, okay, so everybody talks about, you know, what you do contributing-wise. There's so many ways to contribute to a team that if you're not doing well somewhere else, contribute somewhere else, and I can assure you Farca's contributing in many other areas.
Farca's got the brain power for sure. He's a smart player.
His bat will come around.
Yeah.
All right, and I'm certain he's playing a lockdown center field,
yep.
Right? I'm certain he's running the bases like a lunatic, like he always
right.
does, right?
Right.
So he's contributing. He might not, the average might not be there, but that'll come for them. And but he's gonna bring the fire to that team. And to me, that's half the battle. When you're going into a game with fire and energy, energy is contagious. It's contagious, and he brings the energy, and his team feeds off it. And I think they're going to sweep. I do.
They're a team with a guy like Lee, a guy like Mark Braha.
Lee. He's so amazing.
Keeps
I love
doing
him.
It.
But he's just the most humble person I've ever met in my life. This guy, hey, like you guys are talking about. Lee, great shot. You're playing good. I'm going to say something.
Yeah.
I can do better. Okay, Lee. You know, great guy. But their team, listen to all the names you just mentioned.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Great
team. That's a team that, you know, if there is a bad call, which there will be, it won't let them, like, they won and lost the game on bad calls against you guys week one.
Yeah, yeah.
Both calls were bad.
I sold it.
The plate was bad. The thing at second base was bad.
I sold it.
It's not going to be a thing where they're going to harp on it. That was the call. Move on. That's a Mark Braha, Lee, Elsak. They have, like, leaders on this team.
I like that team. I do. And Jeff Misaka, again, doing the job. You know? He doesn't look overpowering, and he's not. But again, was Greg Maddux overpowering?
Right.
You know, I can name you 1,000 pitchers that weren't overpowering.
Right.
That that were great pitchers. 100%. So, you know, keep doing your thing, Jeff. It's nice to watch.
My concern with Get Back is perhaps their outfield defense a little bit. They, for some reason, like you said, I don't know what it is. There's something not there. I don't know what it is.
You have good players that just don't click. It's just not clicking. And I don't know if it's gonna. I really don't.
Yeah,
I really don't.
I mean, Max is a great captain, though. He usually has the vibe.
Again.
Is he bringing the Beatles music? I don't know what's happening.
You're missing. Max is a great captain, great guy.
But
you're missing the point that the league has evolved.
Mm.
And you need to evolve as a captain. You need to evolve as a pitcher. You need to evolve as a hitter. You need to evolve as a fielder.
Right.
The league has evolved. Have you evolved with it? And I'm seeing a lot of no's.
Really?
I see a lot of no's around me. Yeah, absolutely. And you'll see it. You'll see it as... by the way, I just want to tell you, Eshko is a great captain.
Yes.
This guy is the kind of captain that you need in this league over and over again.
Well.
And he's a great drafter because he's going to draft the best player available.
He's proven to be the great drafter in cold-blooded. He's proven to be a great drafter with the Knights and then made the moves also and then again this year.
You know, the funniest thing is, you know, last year, I had a decent year last year, not a great year.
Right.
You know, I thought, I mean, my defense is always going to be solid.
As it should be. That should be constant.
That's constant. And my hitting wasn't great. I could have hit better. You know, but when I was talking to guys, and it's funny because I'd ask them, I said, why, you know, last year, why don't you draft me? He goes, oh, no, next year. I said, okay. So Everybody passed on me eight rounds this time, except, you know, I went down. And I think it was because of reputation. But I think if you went and talked to my teammates, I think my teammates would tell you I was a pretty good teammate.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a good teammate, man. Yeah. So I didn't get that, you know?
Right.
But now I'm going to, it's just, get, I'm happy because next year if I'm a captain, make sure I'm an eighth round slot.
Well, we'll talk about that. I think you're improving over
the other eight rounders. No, it doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way.
Hubba Bubba, 3-5 versus the Tigers, 7-1.
Between me and you, I'm pulling for the Tigers. All due is because I'd rather have teams get knocked out and not have to deal with them.
Although they could come down to 7-3, you could go to 7-3. You could catch them, but
yeah,
I guess
again, come to the playoffs.
You could let them go. I get it. Yeah.
Come to the playoffs, as you saw last year, it means nothing. You got to get hot at the right time,
of course,
and you got to get the breaks.
And they have issues in the playoffs. They're going to lose Marty at some point. They're going to lose Abadi at some point. You
and
know.
The rainouts made it worse for them.
It doesn't help them. It hurts them more than anybody.
More than any team.
For sure.
So, you know what? I think you're going to get a Tiger sweep because I think they're going to want to just pour it on as much as they can before they start losing guys.
Right.
And they're just a dangerous lineup. I think Eddie can keep them somewhat contained. Mm-hmm. They have to play great defense, and they have a decent defense. I just don't think it's great. It's good enough where they're not going to make any mistakes. I think they're going to make mistakes, mm-hmm. and you can't do that versus the Tigers. You just can't. You can't give them extra outs, because if you do, they're going to make you pay, as you can see. They're going to do it over and over and over again.
Right.
Whether it be paying that you walk somebody when you shouldn't have, you're making an error, give them an extra out, you can't do it. Mm-hmm. You cannot do it. You got to play clean. You got to play smart. And, you know, like guys like Jack Abadi, I'll never let them rest on their laurels.
Right.
You know, because he just wants to win every game, every game, every game, every game. So, as good as they think they are, he's going to keep pushing them. So, I'm going to go sweep.
That leads me into my thing. By the way, you mentioned Eshko as a captain. I mean, they had some guys tossed out for minimal, we had a crazy umpire there.
So many ejections this year.
Yes.
And by the way, I wasn't one of them.
I thought Ruby's was warranted, although people told me how'd Ruby get kicked out. When you see a guy that's crazy, or as someone told me in a different situation, when you see a dog barking on that side of the street right there, don't walk right in front of him when you see it. You know, you saw the guy was agitated and annoyed.
Right,
you
saw
that.
Right.
He tossed out people for nothing.
Right.
Eshko, to his credit, stayed in the game, made sure everyone else stayed in the game, didn't get anybody else tossed, didn't talk to the other team. I mean, it wasn't fun. No one wants to play under circumstances like that under a microscope.
Right.
You
it's
know?
It's tough. Listen.
But Ruby, you can't go up to the barking dog. You saw the guy was Mejnoon that day.
Right. It's like going to a pit bull and
why tell him anything?
Him.
Just shut your mouth. That's all. You saw he was crazy.
Right. No, I get it. And sometimes emotion gets the best of you, but and I'm surprised, you know, I guess Eshko didn't even have a chance to calm it down. Like, he was thrown out so quick, you know. But Eshko's a great captain, and I think his team is a great team. I think they have holes. And I think you're going to have more guys get thrown out, by the way, this year. Be ready. Because I'm watching people playing with a lot of emotion.
Yeah.
And everything's on a short, short, short leash.
Yeah.
So,
it was a little too short in certain circumstances.
I agree.
It was too short. We're not here to... The key is respect the other team, respect the umpires. That's all. We shouldn't have to play under a microscope either. But, you know, everyone's got to use their heads. Stay in the game.
My new motto is kill them with kindness.
Yeah, that's all. I mean, that's
you
what you got to do.
I struck out my first at bat after, let me tell you something. After working since September, 3 days a week, right? In the killing it, my first at bat I come up. And I looked at six straight pitches. And the third one, the third strike, which I thought was a little high.
Right.
All right. Last year, I probably would have been like, what, you know, terrible.
Right.
We got to kill him with kindness.
That's it.
I realized it. And because I think I did that, we got the call out at second base.
You know
the
what?
Whole day, I was killing him with kindness.
Maybe.
And we got the call at second base. At
You're not going to get the strike back. You're going to be
it's
out
over.
No matter what you tell him.
So I told him it was the right strike. I said, I should have swing. I got to swing the bat.
Yeah.
You know, we got to kill him with kindness. And that's my new
Even
motto.
Even if you told him, I think you missed that one. But then you leave. It's fine. They'll all handle that.
And I won't even say that anymore. I'm going to say you were right.
Hubba Bubba versus Tigers. I have to give Hubba a game.
Yeah?
And here's why.
Tell me.
I've been on 7-1 teams. This team is different. They could do it. They could go 9-1, 11-1, 13-1. I've been
not
on first place teams.
They're not going 13-1.
It is almost impossible. This is the challenge to the Tigers. how do you keep that intensity when you are running away with the one seed? It's very, very hard. They almost and should have lost the game to slap in the base last week.
And I think that's what's going to help them.
It could help them.
You understand?
But it's also showing that, like, are they beatable? Yes. They were down 8-5 to the worst team in the league with two outs and nobody on in the seventh.
But maybe that's just who they are.
Maybe they just can't lose. Maybe they're going to be 13-1 or 12-2.
Look at the New York Rangers.
Yeah.
They have to be down to play well.
Yeah, it's true.
Right?
It's true. It's right? Crazy, so, but it's true.
That's what they need. Maybe that, you know, sometimes you need that. You need that. But I just think you have guys like Jack Abatti, Eshko, who's a champion, you know, won it last year. He's a champion. They have guys on that team who are champions, who are veterans, who I think when they come to the field, they're coming to play. They want to win.
My point is I like the desperate guy. I like that in life also.
I get it.
The rich guy investing in something versus the guy that needs to, you know, work to make a living.
But the guy who's
desperate.
Give me the desperate guy. Also makes mistakes.
Could be.
You understand?
Yes.
When you feel the pressure, how are you going to handle that pressure?
Yes. No margin of error.
No margin.
Sweating the small things instead of don't worry, it'll be fine.
You know, what's going to happen when you have bases loaded? You're up 3-2 bases, you know, or second and third, and Jack Abatti's coming up, and you have Jimmy behind them. What are you doing there?
There's no arguing with the Tigers.
You know?
7-1 speaks for 7-1. That's a sick record. You don't see it a lot in this league. You don't see 7-1 that often.
But they're not going 13-1 because they still have the playoffs.
Okay, I hear you. Yada, 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 3-5, or slap in the base, 1-7.
I'm going to go split.
Really?
Yeah, I'm gonna give slap in the base one game. Because I mean, I would like to think Nate B has too much pride to go 1-9. You know? I mean, that's just a horrible, horrible record.
Yeah.
You know, one win in 10 tries? I mean, come on, you're a better pitcher than that. And again, yada, yada, yada is a good team, but they're not a dominant team where I don't think they could. I'm going to see split. I'm going to go with the split there.
Nabi and Slap in the base are in a situation this year where it's anything that can go wrong will go wrong, and they feel that way. That's the problem with that team.
It's a mentality.
They know it's coming. They know it's coming. You're talking to a Met fan, a diehard Met fan my whole life. It sometimes gets ingrained in you sometimes.
Let me explain something. That'll never happen
with
any team.
These guys know that something can go wrong, and when it does, they don't know how to self-correct.
But now let me ask you something. What happens when that team is expecting something to go wrong, but it doesn't? And they say, hey, look, it didn't go wrong.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
Things change.
It could happen.
Momentum changes in an instant.
Yes.
In an instant, momentum can change, right? And I think when you have Nate B., yes, he's 1-7. He's been swept a couple of times, but I just think...
It's still Nabi up there.
It's still Nabi.
He's still throwing
hard. You know
what
I'm saying? He's still throwing hard. And yes, the batter's caught up and all that, but...
But his defense.
Right, his defense. Again, he just drafted horribly.
No, he's not a good drafter.
He's just not, you know?
Why does he want to be captain?
Again, Nabi, all due respect.
Go in the draft. You're going to be a first-round pick. Go in the draft.
I'll never take a pitcher in the first round.
Okay, so I'll be a second-round pick
if
all TIs are captains.
I just won't do it.
Okay.
It doesn't make sense to me.
I mean, he's going to be a top pick somewhere.
He's going to be a top pick, and you're going to play on a great team. But, it's hard for a pitcher specifically to be a captain, more than any other position. Really is, because when you're on the mound, the ball's in your hand. Every pitch, it's in your hand. It's in your hand. All the pressure is on you. When you have to deal with all the other guys too, it's a lot to deal with. It takes the mind off your pitching.
I always felt the best position to be captain, and you see this in MLB, they become managers, is the catcher. This guy sees everything from this view. He's talking to the umpire all day. And he's catching every ball from the pitcher. He knows if the guy's hitting the spots, hard, soft, and he has a different perspective. I love when a catcher's captain, but we don't have it.
I also think it's the individual. Like, I'm sorry, I see the game differently than everybody else. I truly believe that. And I'm not saying it in, I mean, I grew up in this game. I played at high levels of baseball growing up. I think I see the game differently. You know, I do. I see players differently. I see things in players that other people might not see. You know, and I think that's why it's an individual type of thing. And that's why I think I next year, God willing, I'll be a good captain. But again, my focus right now is helping this team do everything we got to do to win.
I'm going yada, yada, yada to sweep. I'm saying goodbye. Time to say goodbye to slap in the base.
What happens if they go 1-9 then? I mean,
it's going to get ugly.
Are they going to show up?
Oh, they'll show up.
are going to come to play.
They'll show up.
We still have to play them. We haven't played them yet, so yeah. I'm happy. Listen, not, you know, make them worse. You know, it's fine.
They'll show up. I bet you they even win a game some way, but I just don't think when they count, they could win a game this team. They just don't know how to win.
They're going to win a game this week. Going to win a game this week.
Yada, yada, yada. Will regret that loss the whole season if they lose one.
You think?
Because, yeah, they're in a battle for their lives. They have the scheduling advantage this week.
Right now, who are they tied with?
Hubba Bubba, who's playing the Tigers.
Who's playing the Tigers.
Got to assume.
Did they play the Tigers yet? They did, and they won one. That's
who?
The...
Yada?
Yada, right? Yada beat them once, right?
Yeah.
They beat the Tigers once.
Yeah, they're a good team.
They're a good team. They're in a position.
They're a good
team. They're the better team, but I just think slapping the base will pull one out.
I'm high on yada, yada, yada.
And I think they'll make the playoffs. They will. And they're dangerous if they do make the playoffs.
Well, there you have it. Teddy Ishak. What an interview. I had fun.
It was a fun interview. I enjoyed it. It wasn't my verbose type of self.
No, but you know what? We got to get into the brain power a little bit.
The brain power is a little different. The emotion.
Instead of just the emotion, there's so many layers to T.I.
There's a lot of layers, guys. I'm a deep... See, again...
We're first peeling the onion now.
The misconception of me is that I'm this crazy, crazy, crazy guy. I'm really, really, really not. I play with emotion. Yes. But there's always a method, usually, to my madness.
Mm-hmm.
There's reasons I do things.
You joined so late. We're still first learning about you now.
I know. But you know what? Guys know me. There's a reason I know what I'm doing out there. I really do. And it's funny. On this team, it's hysterical because these guys, anytime I go and say a word to the umpire, like, no! It's like, I'm like, guys, I know what I'm doing. I'm not, you know, it's,
maybe
it's
now
funny.
They'll start... trusting you a little bit more to go there or whatever.
So one more thing that I did wear today that I, you know.
Oh, wow.
No, it just, I forgot to do it, the shirt, man. You know, I think everybody should be wearing these. I think we should all have them because it's a hot shirt, the YMSL. I'm always representing the YMSL now, dude. This is what I'm about, you know.
I love it.
This is a great shirt. And you got one, too.
I got one, too. I'm not wearing mine today.
Isn't it a great shirt?
I love it. You know?
So
you got one for KJ also.
Yeah, I think I'm going to order one for everybody in this league. You know, why not? I think that would be fun. Oh, well, by the way, let's say congratulations to everybody who had the babies. It's nonstop in this league, which is just great. You know, our community keeps growing, and it's a beautiful thing. I love you all.
MC, Farka, Ralph Hannon, Ruby Shahabar.
Love it.
Unbelievable stuff.
Love it. And next year, by the way, you're going to have even more recruits coming in next year.
I hope so.
It's good. This league is only going to get better and better and better. I hope you give me more of a, you know, I'm willing to do anything for the league. You know, I have some great input.
We donated the drinks again, this time in honor of?
We had Jack Abadi and Zach for making that team, guys. You guys are amazing. So proud of you guys. The league is proud of you. We're all proud of you. We know you guys will kill it. And
T.I., Teddy Ishak, God bless you. Thank you so much.
Love you guys.
Great job. Great job. You brought it. Like, you always bring it. Nothing can stop what's coming.
That's my thing. You know, my team doesn't want me to say it too often because this is like last year thing, but it's a way of life.
That's it.
And it's an mentality. Can stop what's coming, boys. Nothing.
T.I., baby. Thank you.
Love you. The honeys getting money, playing fellas like dummies. I love it when you call me big. You gotta get up in your waist, please don't shoot up the place. Why? 'Cause I see some ladies tonight that should be having